Good morning. Great to have you with us here at Unity in Walnut Creek. We are taking a journey into the exploration of wholeness itself today. And we have wonderful music to support that journey. But the real opportunity here is to use the focus, the faith, the love, the awareness to touch that magnificent spiritual being that you are. Thank you for joining us.
Will you please rise? Join us in singing God is good all the time.
Because it's a truth.
God is good.
God is good
all the time.
All the time.
God is good.
God is good
all the time.
All the time.
Well, God's filled with compassion. God's love is everlasting. God is good.
God is
all the time. God is love.
God is love.
All the time.
All the time.
Oh, God is love.
God is love.
All the time.
All the time.
Well, God's filled with compassion. God's love is everlasting. God is love.
God is love.
All the time.
God's love is everlasting. God is good.
God is good
all the time.
God is good.
God is good
all the time.
Good morning. My name is Ron, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to Unity of Welcome Creek. Did I say Welcome Creek? Okay, I'm good. I like it.
I like it.
So this is a place where there is so much love and warmth that the veil between our humanness and our spirituality is just a little thinner. So if you are new to our services, I'd like to extend a warm welcome to you. And we would like to meet you out on the patio, and we are very happy that you have joined us today. And if you would turn around and wave with me to our brothers and sisters online, we appreciate you being here, and we want you to know that you add to our spiritual community. Thank you. So let us open our service with the affirming prayer as we attune to the divine presence that lives within each of us and all around us. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. Take a deep breath and take that in. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. And take a deeper breath and let it in deeper. And once again, there is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life, the all-loving goodness of God. Unity is a positive path for spiritual living. We celebrate the uniqueness of each individual's manifestation of God, which comes from us and through us. Our focus is on universal spiritual truths, and today you may hear music and teachings from different spiritual paths. But we know that each of these paths represent just another avenue to that one presence and one power in the universe that we celebrate here today, don't we?
Yeah?
Cool. Yeah. So in our service today, we will be touching on wholeness. Thank you for everyone who joined us last week in our spiritual focus on sacred relationships. And to support our journey through music today, we have Starlight. Yeah. And so as our service unfolds, we invite you to touch a deeper level of that spiritualness within you that hasn't been touched before. You are in a safe place to do that. We want you to touch that beauty and that magnificence that we know you are as a spiritual being. So please remain seated and join us in singing Only One Path.
Standing by your side, feel her soft hand on your shoulder, feel him carrying your load. There is only one power ever shining in the sun. You can rest inside the comfort that thy will always is done. There is only one power, feel the presence deep inside. See her dancing through your troubles, hear her sing sweet lullabies. There is only one power, glowing bright inside your heart. You can rest inside the comfort that you never are apart. There is only one power always standing by your side. Feel a soft hand on your shoulder. feel Him carrying your load. There is only one power ever shining in a sun. You can rest inside the comfort that Thy will always is done.
So take that deep breath. Just gently let go. We enter into our time of prayer and meditation together. Be aware of this beautiful love that flows in and through your being. And if you want, grab a teddy bear and give it a hug. They're going to go on to children that would love to be touched by the love that you put into them. Gently move within and let the simple, beautiful music be part of that journey to the very center of your heart. Immersed in this divine presence, everywhere present. This infinite love flows through our beings. It is this beautiful power through which we call forth true well-being, wholeness, abundance, wisdom, and deep, unlimited peace. Mother, Father, God, I am open and receptive. I feel your love in my heart. And I know that that love provides wholeness in my body. I feel your love in my heart. And I know that love provides wisdom. Clear, powerful wisdom and understanding. For I meet all that is before me with grace and wisdom. I feel your love in my heart. And I send it forth as that power that brings harmony into every relationship, for it blesses and heals. It uplifts and brings new vision. It opens deep and beautiful connection. And this love in my heart, this infinite presence of you, one in me and as me, brings peace. An infinite peace that is deeper than all the activity in my life. I rest in that peace. And from this beautiful place of peace within, I enter into stillness. Sacred, beautiful stillness. A stillness in which I am at one with the One. As guided by the words of the Master, peace, be still. Peace. Be still. Peace. Be. Mother, Father, God, infinite love, beloved presence, how wonderful it is to know your presence in and through me as this love that I am. How wonderful to be able to send this love forth to heal and bless and uplift. And from my heart this love flows as compassion and care, joy and peace. It travels to my body as radiant life, lifting me into wholeness and health. It expresses in my mind and heart as wisdom and understanding. It touches everyone dear to me, and I hold them in this place of wholeness, seeing their beauty and their peace, their healing and their strength. And this love flows from my heart. Flows across this spiritual community, becoming a part of the light and wisdom that blesses each one and everyone in their lives. This love enfolds every prayer request brought here, for we know with each that you are one with that which is the very highest, and call it forth in your life. This love flows from my heart, across the communities in which we live, across our nation and the nations of the world, drawing forth the deep desire for peace in all hearts. And this love flows from our hearts. It touches all who would join us in prayer, whether in mosque or synagogue, temple or church, whether in prayer at home or on the hillsides, or in seeking to know you, we are one. And this love flows forth from our hearts. It blesses this beautiful earth and all her creatures. It brings healing and care to those touched by her storms and brings peace. And this love enfolds the earth to touch the heart of every single person. For you are that love in every heart, and in that love, we are one. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. Please join me. Divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And again, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world. And once again, divine love flows through my heart, enfolding and blessing the world.
All is well.
It is so, here, now, in the presence of true peace. Amen.
I have to say may well be simple, but they're true. Until you give your love, there's nothing more that you can do. Love is the opening door. Love is what we came here for. No one could offer you more. Do you know what I mean? Have your eyes really seen?
You say it's very hard to leave behind the life we knew. but there's no other way. And now it's really up to you. Love is the key we must turn. Truth is the flame we must burn. Freedom, the lesson we must learn. Do you know what I mean? Have your eyes really seen? Love is the key we must turn. Truth is the flame we must burn. Freedom, the lesson we must learn. Do you know what I mean? Have your eyes really seen?
Thank you, Starlight. I could listen to you all afternoon. So we're here. We have other things to do, though. So. Hi, good morning. My name is Veronica Wolf, and it is truly my pleasure to welcome you here today to Unity of Walnut Creek and to highlight a few of the many upcoming activities that we have. Our annual teddy bear drive has begun, and our book center is selling really cute, cuddly, and unique teddy bears today and next Sunday. So bring your donated bears to service with you. You see some of them around here today. And they can receive our love and hugs before we give them to children for the holidays. We are delighted to have Reverend Jim Lee join us next Sunday. And he invites you to attend his afternoon workshop and embark on a transformational journey of inner awareness and to co-create the life of your dreams. If you know Reverend Jim, it will be an extraordinary experience. And you are invited to join your Unity family for Thanksgiving. We are here to give thanks and enjoy Unity friends. You can sign up on Sunday or in the Book Center during the week. To find out about these and other activities, please visit the website or take a look in your bulletin. And while our guest musicians prepare for another special musical experience, I'm going to invite you to take a short minute to greet those folks immediately around you. And when you hear the gong, we're all going to come back together, okay? Okay, please return to your seats. Thank you.
You can sway or sing or join. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. If we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me,
when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
So please swallow your pride if I have things you need to borrow, for no one can feel those of your needs that you won't let show. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'd understand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
Lean on me
when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. Somebody to lean on.
You just call on the brother when you need a hand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
I just might have a problem that you'd understand.
We all need somebody to lean on.
There is a load you have to bear that you can't carry. I'm right up the road. I'll share your load if you just call me. Just call me when you need a friend.
Thank you. Boy, you guys can do glitz. To everybody who made last night possible, all the love and the care and the good food and everything, to all of you, thank you. It was marvelous. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Yes, wow. And then today, okay, today something new begins. We have been working towards having our connection classes, a new experience here, because we understand one of the real desires for people is to connect more closely and get to know more people in the spiritual community and have people to share in your spiritual growth who hold like minds. And that So we have these special connection classes that just 4 weeks, and they begin this afternoon. And whether you're newly here for your 24th year or it's your first time, doesn't matter. Jump in and let yourself experience this new experience in unity. Now, I do want to share with you that I am being very generous. I am sharing one of my favorite people. Next Sunday, Jim Lee's going to be here. Few of you have experienced Jim. Jim is a good friend, and he is one of those people that I go to because he knows it at depth. Marvelous, marvelous teacher. Going to be here for Sunday services and take us into the journey of some of the deep, powerful steps that take us into true abundance in his workshop afterwards. So, again, I'm so glad I get to share him with you. Have you ever noticed that thing where you get a question and you just don't get it once? You get it two or three or four times, it begins coming up. And that's kind of Spirit's way of saying, okay, I got something for you to look at. Well, there's a question that's been coming up for me a number of times. And so I thought, well, maybe I need to take a look at it. It goes something like this. Well, Reverend David, there's this thing going on in my life. What in the world do you mean God is good? You ever get that question ever occur to you? And you come here and we go, God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Except for that time. Okay? So, that's the question. Because when it's going good, that's not hard to understand. No, it's wonderful. My relationships are working. God is so good. After she said that, God dropped a little bit. Okay? You know how it goes. Okay, so what is this? And one of the reasons that we go back to this teaching and embrace this affirmation is that we come into places in our life of serious challenge. And in those places, there is a choice before us. Where do we place our attention? Let me give you an example. Little girl, 4 years old, polio. Little four-year-old girl coming down with polio. Now, the polio set in her legs. Okay. The doctor sits there with she and her mother and says to her, you will never walk again. Her mother says, yes, she will. Now, can you imagine what it would be like to be 4 years old, find yourself sick in a hospital, and be told you'll never walk again? You know, I got a 2.5-year-old in my house, and a limitation on energy is not within that concept of life. And being still and not running certainly isn't. Wow, 4 years old. And the doctor was just being completely honest. Now, with her mother's support, and understand this, the support for this little girl was not easy. Okay, African-American family, rural Tennessee, deep poverty, big family, many children. Imagine what that's like to, at that time when polio was affecting so many children, to suddenly have that huge demand upon a family that was stretched for their resources in every way. But her mother helped her keep focus on taking what steps they could. 2 years later, 6 years old, she was able to get metal braces so she could stand. And then, first step. 6 years old. 10 years later. 16 years old. She ran to a bronze medal in the Olympic Games. 4 years later at 20, 3 gold medals in the Olympic game. Fastest woman in the world, Wilma Rudolph. I remember seeing her run. I remember that interview where she mentioned as a child she'd had polio. Now when you're in the experience of the four-year-old and the disease, it's hard to feel that goodness. But the nature of God, the nature of this divine presence that is the creative force within these bodies, that gives us this amazing, perfect presence that we call into physical expression, the nature of that presence is wholeness. So when wholeness isn't there, it doesn't mean God isn't there. It means I haven't brought it all into manifestation. That divine goodness is there as the potential within my experience. Yeah, you know. And how do you get there? Now her mother didn't have that affirmation. But she had another one. Yes, you will. Put the focus and take the step towards the wholeness which was her true nature. Every time that divine is there, this is the force that we are one with. It is within us. It is what we create with. Now, I wouldn't want to create the impression that everyone that gets polio gets up and wins Olympic medals. But it doesn't work that way. Okay, I have a wonderful cousin, and some time ago I shared her story at depth, so I'll just touch it today. But as a young girl, she had polio. Now, the polio affected her from her neck down to the point where there were times where she couldn't breathe. She was in an iron lung. And gradually, she began to be able to breathe on her own. But in her life, she never gained control of her body below her neck. She was a quadriplegic for the rest of her life. But she reached for wholeness as she could find it for herself. First of all, to give expression to what was within her. So she took a pencil in her teeth and began to draw. Beautiful art. And one of the most exquisite things that came out of her drawing were children's faces, because she so loved children. So actually believing that she could live a life of wholeness, she set out into the world in a wheelchair to open herself into a life that would have meaning due to her opportunities, due to her a wonderful partner in life. They married and together adopted over 9 children with disabilities, which she raised as their mother. I had 3 healthy, and I can't begin to perceive of what that was. Okay. That was her wholeness. For her, it wasn't the body. For her, it was the spirit of love and care and compassion. God is good. God is good. And all the time. And when it looks the worst, it is the most important time to remember that one. Because it's there. It is always there because the divine is wholeness itself. And that potential is there within every experience that we're in. One of the people who impacted my life in so many ways, man who became known the world over, Mahatma Gandhi. Young man, given the opportunity for education, sent to England from India to go to law school, came back to his home, was so insecure he could not talk to people. So no one wanted him for a lawyer. Finally, somebody, they brought him a case for $10. He was in the courtroom, he stood up to talk, and he could not say a word. He was utterly silent. He fled in embarrassment from the courtroom. Now, his wasn't body. His was emotion. And yet, over years, we got to see the wholeness that was in that life. And what he did. The truth is, he couldn't do law. He just wasn't socially or emotionally capable of handling such a thing. An uncle had a firm where they needed a clerk or something, so they sent him off to this little office in South Africa. He got there and he discovered not only could he not do the law, but his job was to keep track of the accounts, and he didn't even know accounting. And he was ready to fail and go home again. And he looked, instead of outside, at the people that would judge him and all the problems that were there and all the things that intimidated him. He looked inside. And what he found was he had the capacity to change himself. Wholeness. In that situation. Now he had to do that. He had to make a choice. Okay, he had to take a step towards it. His first step was to at least learn accounting so he could take care of the accounts. And he began to learn that and learn this complicated thing that he was involved in, which was, you know, two businesses, two people suing each other over all this complicated stuff. And so he just began to learn, finally figured it out, and then he had to explain it to people as they would ask him questions. So he got to where he could explain this stuff. And finally, it became clear that, yes, his, you know, the person that had hired him was right, was going to win, and basically put the other guy in bankruptcy. And suddenly he went, wait a minute. That's not okay. Because that wasn't what he was there about. It was people just using their power to destroy somebody else. So he had to try to explain that until finally the people, they began to understand, and they actually worked out a way that worked for both of them, and they ended up successfully resolving conflict. And he began to get a glimpse of what a life of wholeness might be about. And then he ran against a system of degradation that was just brutal. Laws were passed to go into another level of subjugation of anyone in South Africa that was black. And that affected, he was a part of the Indian community there, so that affected him. And so suddenly he began to see how important it was if where people really needed to come together. And what he realized was everybody wanted to deal with it, and they all wanted to deal with it the same way. The way we've always done it, with violence. But that wasn't wholeness to him. So he put out a different idea. And some heard him and appreciated it. Thought there might be something there. But then he'd taken the step of putting it out. So he had another step he had to take. He had to take the identity card that put him under that system and burn it before the authority. Otherwise, the wholeness that he found was not something he could live. And his understanding in that step was that he would probably be beaten or killed, or at least spend the rest of his life in prison. That's what happened in that place, in that time. But he took the step to express his own wholeness. He had no idea that that step to say no without any desire for harm to another would eventually lead an entire nation of millions to freedom without violence. That it would destroy a caste system that kept millions as virtual slaves. That it would eventually stop a war. He didn't know that. He just knew that was his next step. And it came from the step before. And it came to the step before. When little Wilma got up on those braces, she had no idea it was about gold medals. She just wanted to stand up and see if she could walk. And she took a step towards wholeness. When Grace put that pencil in her teeth, she had no idea what was going to come out. She didn't know that by being willing to give expression to who she was, that she would bring so much help to so many children. Children that no one else wanted. She just had to take one step towards her wholeness. Because within every situation, God is good all the time. God is good all the time. All the time. God is good. It's there. Now it's potential. We're what makes the difference between potential and manifestation. She could have listened to the doctor and known she'd never run. Why bother getting braces? She's never going to walk anyway. Okay? You can't do anything. You're a quadriplegic. Or, I am going to do that which I can do. A step towards wholeness. So I invite you. The only reason we're doing it isn't about those people. They already did their thing. Okay? It is about those things in our world where we do not experience wholeness. The relationship that keeps replacing the relationship that replaced the relationship that didn't work anyhow. The health challenge that follows the health challenge that follows the... the not enough that follows the not enough. Whether the not enough is money or it's support or it's acceptance or whatever it is. One step is what it takes. But what makes the difference is the direction we step in. Is it towards the wholeness? If it is, then we are calling into manifestation a power and a presence in you, personal to you, that is there to express in and as you in pure, radiant wholeness that is right for your being. One step. So let me ask, would you, if just perchance there's something that shows up in your world that doesn't look like wholeness, okay? Now, every now and then when you're not looking, Spirit will sneak it in on you. So keep your eyes open, okay? Something that doesn't look like wholeness, would you be willing to take a step towards that wholeness? Stay aware of it for this week. So whatever comes up, I will take a step towards wholeness. Willing to do that? Let's say it. I will take a step towards wholeness. Again, I will take a step towards wholeness. Feel the very beautiful, gentle power of that. Again, I will take a step towards wholeness. And when you do, there's an amazing thing that happens. What you discover is, God is good. You're right.
Part of me. We're two branches. you're in me. We're two branches on just one tree. Look around, all you see is part of you and part of me.
We're two branches on just one tree.
On just one tree.
Look in your heart and I see me.
Last time.
I'm in you, you're in me. We're two branches on just one tree. Look around, all you see is part of you and part of me. We're two branches on just one tree. We're two branches on just one tree.
If you would like prayer support for challenges or celebrations, please ask our heart ministers. They are here in the sanctuary after service or out on the patio, and they are wearing the lavender stoles. We have a new experience if you're in the sanctuary today for service. These are the connection cards. They're in the seat pockets in front of you. And if you are new, please go ahead and check that box that I am new to Unity. And if you go ahead and do that, we will send you a special gift and a gift certificate to attend a Unity event as our guest. And we also have a welcome table on the patio and look forward to meeting you out there. If you already are in Unity Connects, just put your name and check that box too. And we would like to help with you, help you on your spiritual journey. That's what this is about, connecting with one another on the spiritual journey. We hope that you'll also share a prayer request on those cards and know that we will be praying with you throughout the week. So please let us know if you are committing to join us in our weekly spiritual focus. The focus this week, the challenge from Reverend David, is one step toward wholeness each day. The ushers will pick up the cards when they pick up the offering toward the end of the music, so you have a minute to fill them out. And now it's time for our prosperity celebration. For credit card donations or for love in action, there are envelopes provided on the back of each chair. So I invite you at Unity, we know the divine seeks to provide us each with abundance. And giving is one of the ways we open ourselves to receive the ever-expanding flow of the divine provision in our lives. So I invite you to now take your tithe love offering in your hand and be aware that God is the source of all of our good. And repeat the affirmation with me together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive, and I am grateful.
We invite you to have fun with this unitized version of a Beatles classic.
Ooh, I need your love, God. Guess you know it's true. All my love, God, fills me through and through.
Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, God, 8 days a week. Loving every day, God, opens up my mind. One thing I can say, God, love you all the time.
Oh, oh,
hold me, love me, hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, God. 8 days a week, 8 days a week, I love. Show I care. Ooh, I need your love, God. Yes, you know it's true. Giving all my love, God, fills me through and through.
Ooh,
hold me, love me, hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, God. 8 days a week.
I love you. 8 days a week is not enough to show I care. Loving every day, God opens up my mind. One thing I can say, God, love you all the time. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, God. 8 days a week, 8 days a week, 8 days a week.
All right. All right. So we've got our kids here. Let's bless them together. Children, you are loved, special, and important. God loves you beautifully through you. Oh, yeah. Almost went back to the old one. Oh. And I want to say we just enfolded our teenagers with that. They are off at a YOU rally and having a wonderful time this weekend, so they're in our hearts too. So please stand and take hands and let's share together our prayer protection. Together, the light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. And the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And our peace song. The love and the light and the peace in the earth right now. So let it shine and have fun.
Brothers and my sisters, all over this land. hammer of justice. It's a bell of freedom. It's a song about love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land. It's a hammer of justice. It's a bell of freedom. It's a song about love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land.